Hello to all of our awesome Lyon County seniors. My name is Kate Castro, and I'm the Healthy Aging Program Coordinator at Healthy Communities Coalition in Lyon County. Today, we are going to talk to you about measuring cups, how to properly use them, and some of the benefits of using measuring cups when we're preparing food. So the items we're going to go over today are flour, white sugar, brown sugar. I just tend to keep mine in a bag. And then some old-fashioned oats or dried oatmeal. So keep on watching to learn some stuff about measuring cups. All right, so the first ingredient that I want to start off with talking about how to measure is just some white sugar. So if you received our measuring cups, there's also a handout that came with them. And on the handout, there's a recipe for some delicious oatmeal raisin muffins. And on the recipe, it calls for 1/3 cup of white cane sugar. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna grab our third cup. Your measuring cups should tell you the quantity of each one. Mine say on the inside here. So this is my 1/3 cup. And when we're measuring, we always wanna make sure we have a utensil with a flat surface so that we can level off any excess of the ingredient to make sure we're getting the exact amount the recipe calls for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick my measuring cup inside of my sugar to get some. And you can see that I have a little bit extra here, more than I need. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my flat edge and I'm just going to scrape off any of that excess so that I can really level out. And now I have a nice clean flat surface with my one cup of sugar. And then I'm just going to add it to the bowl. And that is how you super simply measure sugar. Next, we are going to measure some flour. So the recipe calls for 1 1/4 cup of flour. So I have my big guy, my one cup here, and my fourth cup here. And flour is a little bit different. So when we measure flour, we want to use a spoon to scoop it into our cup. So I'm gonna start with my one cup, and we're just gonna spoon it into our measuring cup until it's full. And just like when we measured our sugar, we're gonna level it off at the end. So you wanna make sure you still keep your straight edge on you as well. And the importance of measuring when we cook is it really makes a difference as to how our recipe turns out. If you have too much or too little of something, then it might not turn out the way you want it to, it might not taste the way you want it to, and sometimes it might not even look the way you want it to. So we really want to make sure that we're trying to get as exact of measurements as we can. So you can see now that my flour is over the top, or over the ledge of my cup, and so I'm going to, again, take my straight edge and scrape off that excess. And now I have my flat surface of flour for my one cup. And then I'm just gonna add it to my mixing bowl. And then to do my 1/4, same thing, I'm going to spoon it in. Good, so I have my overflowing cup, and then taking my flat surface again, scraping off any excess to get my flat surface. Okay, and then adding that to my mixing bowl as well. And that is how you scoop flour. So you always just want to make sure that you have your spoon to scoop your flour into your measuring cup, and then again, like always, our flat surface. So next we will move on to some oats. So one of the other really awesome uses for measuring cups is to measure serving size. Everyone's health is different and everyone has different goals when it comes to their health. For some of us, maybe that's making sure we're not getting too much or too little of any one thing. That could be too much or too little fat, carbohydrates, sodium, proteins, anything like that. And these nutrition labels on the back of all of the items are our best friend, because it tells us exactly how much each serving size is and how much of each thing that you're getting within that serving size. So for example, on these old-fashioned oats, it says the serving size is a half cup. and it says the total fat is 2.5 grams. So that means for every half cup, there's 2.5 grams of fat. And for every half cup, there's 0 milligrams of sodium, 0 milligrams of cholesterol, but there is 27 grams of carbs, and there's also 5 grams of protein. So we really want to pay attention to the nutrition facts, especially if you're trying to watch your intake for any of those items. It's really helpful to know how much we need or how much we don't need. So for the recipe for the oatmeal raisin muffins, it calls for 1 cup of oats. We know that the serving size of this is 1/2 cup. So I'm still going to give the necessary amount for the recipe, but I now know that out of the however many muffins that the recipe makes, there's double the amount of everything listed on the nutrition fact label. So now instead of 27 grams of carbohydrates, there's 54. So the serving size on the back of the nutrition label is super helpful. And nutrition labels in general are just something that could be a really useful tool to us. So I'm just scooping my oats into here. I would stick the whole thing in and scoop it, but I don't think it's big enough. So I've scooped my oats, and again, it's kind of overflowing here. It's round at the top, so I'm gonna take my straight tool and level off the top there. Now I have a good flat surface, and I'm gonna again add it to my mixing bowl. Perfect. And that is one of the amazing benefits to using our measuring cups for our health, for our diet, for checking on the serving size. It's really helpful, so make sure that we're utilizing that as much as you can, and let us know if you see a difference. Alrighty, so the last thing we're going to talk about measuring today is brown sugar. Brown sugar is a little bit special, a little different than other ingredients. So with brown sugar, whenever it calls for a measurement of brown sugar in a recipe or something that you're cooking, you want to pack it down in the measuring cup, which is totally unique to most ingredients. But what we're going to do is I just like to take my measuring cup, and this is again a 1/3 cup, and I just like to scoop it in here. And you notice when you scoop, you're gonna have that uneven surface, and right now it looks like I have way more than I need. But because we pack it down, I just like to use my hand on the edge of the bag. You can even take it out, but it just makes a little bit of a mess. So I keep mine in the bag, and I use my hand to press it down. And when I press it down, what looked like I had too much now becomes the perfect amount when I pack it down with my hand. So now you can see that I have this nice flat surface here with my measuring cup. So from here, I have my bowl, and I just like to tap it a little bit, and it comes right out perfectly. And you can see here in the shape of the measuring cup. So that is how you do brown sugar. Remember to always pack it. After you pack it, if it's still overflowing a little bit, you can still use your straight edge to level it off, but we just want to make sure that that is nice and tight in the measuring cup when we're measuring brown sugar. Thank you so much to everyone for watching, and I hope you learned something from this video, and stay healthy.